Hi, in this video, we will go over one of the questions from the review exercises for exam number one. In this question, they are asking us to write a prologue relation that has the name C phi, such that this C phi counts the number of phi's in a given vector. And this given vector, we're going to see that as a list. And we don't care about the length. So in this example of the possible execution of C5, so here we got the query prompt, we call it C5, and there are two parameters. You see the first parameter is the list, and in this list, I want to get in X the number of files. So I see that there are two files, I'm expecting that X is 5. Then, what we need to do is then we say, well, C5, fact. And one possible thing in my code will be that the list is actually empty. If the list is empty, then I got zero files. There is no files, and this is a fact. Now, the other possibility is that the list is not empty. Now, the first element in the list is a 5. There may be something else. So this is the rest of the list. So this is the head of the list. I see a 5. And then I want my answer in P. Then what I will say is that I want to know how many 5's are in T. Then I need to call what we need to say here is first, I don't want to backtrack and skip this option, because if we backtrack, I'm going to be able not to count this file. So I'm going to say cut, stop it there. This is a file. This is the right option. Don't try to look for another option for this one. And then let's see, C5T, give me that in X. So how many files are in T? Then the answer for P is whatever is in X plus 1. Then we're going to say X is, P is X plus 1. So P is my answer. So P, I know for sure I have 1 because I see 1 here, and I don't know how many more are in T. So I count those, I get that in X, then I get the answer in my P. Now, the other possibility is that this is not a 5, and then we say, okay, then I don't really care, so that's an underscore. I still count the rest. I know it's not empty, so at least there is something else. Then I got the P, and then in this case, I just do C5T, comma, P. So let's go back to that exclamation mark again. So that exclamation mark, the only thing that is preventing when I get an answer that is not gonna skip counting one of the files. Because if I don't have that, I'm gonna get initially the right answer. But if I'm looking for another answer, it's gonna come back and say, well, I count this file, and it's asking me for another possibility. Then, I see another possibility. I can ignore the phi and don't count the phi and get another possible answer. So this is just preventing that, and that's what we call a cut.